No, it's good. So good morning, everyone. So I would like to thank the organizers for this invitation. So let me see how this works. So I came here to show some, to share some results that we obtained at Vanderbilt University in collaboration with Dr. Gabor. And we are looking at some anti-aging effects of DDW in Caenorhabditis Elegans. So just a brief outline of my talk. I'm gonna talk a little bit, introduce you to C.elegans as a model for aging. And I'm gonna talk about a little bit about manganese toxicity. It was the model that we used to induce aging in this animal model, and going briefly to results and discussion. So just an introduction, what is Caenorhabditis elegans, or C. elegans, as I'm going to refer during this talk. It's a very small nematode, so it reaches 1 millimeter long as an adult. It has a transparent body, and it feeds with bacteria, and it can be grow in liquid media or in agar. It's a solid medium. It has a large brood size, so approximately 300 progeny per hermaphrodite. So this is very good for high throughput screenings of toxicants and also antioxidants or protective compounds. It has a very short lifespan of approximately 18 days in the wild type. And it also has a very short reproductive cycle, which is represented here. So the reproductive cycle, it's approximately 3.5 days only. So as you can appreciate here, the embryonic development goes through 14 hours, and then the egg hatches, releasing L1 larva, which goes to L2, L3, and L4 stages in very short period of time. And during this period, the worm matures, and especially the reproductive system matures, and then reaches the young adult that is able to reproduce, restarting the whole cycle again. So something that is very interesting in this pathway, in the cycle, is that when this first larval stage, when the animals are in a starved plate, so there is no bacteria to feed with, they go to this downward larval stage, which can, this worms can survive for approximately 3 months, which is more than the triple than the regular lifespan. So this is a very interesting pathway. So many people are working, so many researchers are working with this downward larval stage because it can be a key role for aging and longevity. So something else that's very interesting is that 60 to 80% of the worm genome, it has homology with the human genome. This is very interesting for these studies. And also something very interesting is the ease of genetic manipulability that these worms provide. So it's very easy to knock out genes and observe the effects of this lack of genes, and also to generate transgenic lines. For example, you can insert a green fluorescent protein to a promoter of a gene, or to a protein by itself, and you can see the pattern expression of this protein using an immunofluorescence microscope, as you can observe here. So disease of genetic manipulability led to the findings of several pathways, and one of the main studied pathways in C. elegans is aging. So C. elegans is an ideal model to elucidate causes of and molecular mechanisms of aging, especially because of that short lifespan, and also the genetic manipulability, of course. And what is very interesting is that as humans, C. elegans experience age-related neurodegeneration, sarcopenia, which is the loss of muscles, and also lipofuscin accumulation. So as you can appreciate here, we have a young adult, so you can see the body band, so this worm moves freely and looking for food search, new food search sources, I mean. And as this animal ages, as you can observe here, it changes completely the morphology. This animal is still alive, it's still feeding, but it can't move anymore to search for new food sources. And as you can observe here, this is the same animal it's immunofluorescence figure, and you can see that there is accumulation of lipofuscin, which is very similar to what it happens in humans. You can see accumulation of lipofuscin as they age. So there are more than 50 genes that were found to be related to this aging process. And the one that's well studied in worms, it's the DAF16 gene. So DAF16 gene encodes a transcriptional factor called DAF16. And this transcriptional factor, it's very important for anti-aging or longevity effects in C. elegans. So under normal conditions, DAF16 is bound to the nucleus and activates the transcription of antioxidants. So DAF16 belongs to this cascade of the DAF2 insulin-like pathway, and this cascade controls dour formation, progeny production, stress response, and also lifespan. So if you understand DAF16 increasing the transcription of this antioxidant proteins, it would increase lifespan. On the other hand, when insulin-like ligands bind to the DAF2 receptor, it triggers a phosphorylation cascade, which includes kinases like AGE and AKT, and as consequence, they phosphorylate DAF16, which becomes inactive, and it doesn't go to the nucleus to activate the production of antioxidants. So, as you can see here, the figure, it has a lot of genes here, but I just want to show you, the square would be the wild type, and when you knock out the DAF16 gene, you have a significant decrease in lifespan. On the other hand, when you knock out DAF2 receptor, these worms with this DAF2 knockout, they live twice longer than the wild types. So this pathway is really interesting. And something that I would like to mention is that DAF16 is the homolog of the mammalian FOXO. And FOXO has been shown to be related to tumor suppression in tumoral cell lines. So when there is increase in FOXO, there is tumor suppression. So I think this is very interesting to mention. In our model, we use manganese as an inducer of toxicity and decreasing lifespan. So manganese is an essential metal, but exposure to high concentrations of manganese leads to several cell effects. So it's mainly mitochondrial dysfunction because manganese accumulates in mitochondria. There is energy depletion, oxidative stress, activation of necrotic and apoptotic pathways. And this mainly happens in dopaminergic neurons, causing dopaminergic degeneration. So it's very interesting to mention that manganese toxicity, called manganism, shows resemble Parkinson's disease symptoms. So people, they have tremors. So it has been used as a model for Parkinsonism. In C. elegans, manganese recapitulates the effects of mammalian dopaminergic system. It shows as a general toxicity effects, osmoregulation defects, so the worm shows cellular alterations, as you can observe here. There is decrease in body size, so the worms treated with 35 millimolar of manganese, they show smaller size than untreated worms, and they are arrested in the larval stage, which means that they don't develop as well as untreated worms. And manganese causes decrease in longevity, and that's why we use this model. So we hypothesized that given all the beneficial properties of the depleted deuterium water that we hear so far, in especially in anti-cancer research, we hypothesized that DDW would have anti-aging activity in C. elegans. So going to some, just to explain for you the treatment paradigm, because worms are so different than mammalian systems. So we use synchronous L1 C. elegans. So the very first larval stage, so they are more sensitive to change, oxidative changes, and et cetera. And they were treated for 30 minutes to manganese chloride, 35 millimolar. And right after, manganese was washed off, and these animals were treated with depleted deuterium water for 48 hours with two different doses.